Whoo, everyone. The wait is over. I've got my ThinkSpot invitation. I thought, great. Let's log in and upload things. I'm a creator of web novels and YouTube, and I thought, oh, I want to be a ThinkSpot creator as well. So I made my account, which was very easy. It was just username and password, and that's it. I then gave a bit more of my infos, and then a tutorial started. You can do the tutorial again, and we will do this in a moment, but I want to say what shocked me. Yeah? What shocked me was first that I was already following people, this guy's there on the left, without ever deciding for them. So they were standardized that I follow them, and it's not even that they're all the contributors on this platform, but as selected few. So I don't know what criteria they selected these contributors, but I had no choice. But I can probably unsubscribe them. We try this. Following. Do you want to unfollow? Yes, please. Okay, but she looks interesting. So let's follow her again. Yeah, good or bad, whatever. So, but the crucial thing is, I can't be a contributor. So this ThinkSpot thing seems to be hierarchical. So you have the contributors and you have the normal users, and only contributors can contribute, can post podcasts, can post videos, and the users can only comment on them. Okay, I looked around for a bit and read their FAQs, and this is the conclusions I had from them, but I'm not 100% sure if this will be the same in future as well. Let's do the tutorial. Follow a contributor or media partner. The selected contributor's content will subsequently appear in your feed. Additionally, you can access the entirety of a contributor's content from their profile page. So here on the upper right side, I've got recommended contributors, and yeah, I can follow them. Good. Next. Discourse button. While browsing your ThinkSpot feed, a contributor's profile page, click the Discourse button to open up the page and explore the discourse in depth. Add a reference. Part 1. To begin adding a reference, highlight a portion of text by clicking it, then click the subsequent plus icon. Add a reference. Part 2. You may support, dispute, or clarify a sentence. Enter the URL for the source of your reference and add a comment. Press play. Begin listening to a podcast. Annotate while listening. Have thoughts about this part of the podcast or want to make notes? Your posts will be timestamped according to your place in the podcast. Okay, nice feature. Share any podcast or ebook annotation. Want to share snippets of a podcast via email or Twitter? Click this icon to share a 20-second clip of podcast audio. Add to my library. Add media to your library. Love a podcast or ebook? Add it to your library to access later. Select a sentence and annotate. Click on the text you would like to annotate. This will highlight the text to indicate your specific selection. Enter your annotation. Use the privacy filter to post a public annotation, add an annotation to your private notes or post within a private group. Annotation list. Here you find a list of annotations per chapter. These include your annotations along with those of the others and authors as well. Alright, that was the tutorial. So, like you notice, nothing about being a contributor. We as users are just customers or just there to discuss and annotate the posts of the contributors. Honestly, I don't like this two-rank society which differs between contributors and users. I mean, I'm used that all people are equal on the platforms, and only those who pay are more equal than the others. But I'm not used to this divide between contributors and users, and honestly I feel a bit slighted by it. Yeah, I see myself as contributor and creator of art and content, not a literature critic or a user who just reads and gives their comments to content. I'm not sure about how I will use this, or even whether I will use this at all. So let's just look at some of the contributors. So let's choose Jordan B. Peterson. He's currently not on the helm of his own page because he has medical issues. But yeah, Jordan is still taking some time off. In the meantime, his team will continue posting his previously prepared content. So yeah, no problem with that. So explore the discourse. All the best, yeah, all the best for me as well. So what else can I do here? Yeah, in my first tutorial I did, there was the part that you can react differently, more nuanced than in other platforms. Oh, we just click through everything and we will find it if it's there. So I clicked on the bubble. Okay. Save this post. All right. Share it. Okay, the annotating feature works. Add reference. No, I don't want to add reference at the moment. All right, but I really miss the smiley thingies. Okay, so I explain it. Maybe they have disabled it at the moment. So you've got 6 different types of smileys. You can disagree, you can be provocative about it, insightful about it, agree, like, and recommend. Yeah, I rather like this feature. Okay, the only feature I like that they have disabled. But oh, maybe they haven't disabled and I'm just too stupid to find it. Let's try a different post. More senseless diversity ideology in the STEM fields. Ooh. Oh, here it is. Great. Disagree. Provocative, insightful, agree, like, and recommend. Let's look at some of the ebooks they have here. This is ThinkSpot's media library, and these ebooks are on the platform, but of course they are not free. Okay, let's check out 12 Rules for Life. Purchase is on TS. Okay, so they have a system to purchase those directly. Let's try this in old book. Add to my library. Okay, I tried an old book because most of them are on Project Gutenberg, because their copyright doesn't run anymore, 1886. So I think it's quite fair that they offer it to download free of cost as well. So let's see the podcasts. You have to refresh. Search. So we have Peterson's podcast, Open College by Dr. Stephen Hicks. Let's look at this. Okay, it works. Okay, what next? We have videos. I think we saw. Okay, let's just check it out. No, I want videos. Okay, let's check out Chocos or Yokos. And it switched to ebooks again. Oh man. Okay, this is totally normal for a site who just launched. I want to throw no shade at all at this. I mean, these are just the little beginning bugs, no problem.
This is Jocko Podcast number 101, with Echo Charles and me, Jocko Willink.
I have been looking for the increase speed button, but I haven't found it. I really like the increase speed feature on YouTube and while listening to audiobooks and podcasts. Yeah, but I don't know, maybe they have planned it for the future. Okay, nothing happens. So let's just look at what kinds of books they have at the moment. This looks like Jordan Peterson selected the books. We have Nietzsche, we have him at first as first book, we have Dostoevsky, we have the only other famous Canadian author besides Jordan Peterson, Voltaire, Descartes, yeah. Oh, here from Jocko Willink. Okay, from the other contributors, the books. This makes sense. A bit of H.G. Wells. Okay, why not? Oh, Jane Austen. Who added this? Ibsen. Grimm's Fairy Tales. The very Jordan Peterson selection, because he's a younger of Jung, of Carl Jung, and Carl Jung loves fairy tales because of all the archetypes in them. Dickinson, oh, of course, The Manifesto from Karl Marx, okay. Ooh, Kafka. I just wanted to critique that it's very focused on English literature, but yeah, we have a bit of Russian with Dostoevsky and now a bit of does Kafka count as German author? I'm not sure about it. I think he is from the Czechai or Slovakai, but wrote in German? I think he wrote in German. So more English guys and American guys. And okay, Nietzsche, yes. I'm really missing Carl Jung. I would have thought that some of his books found it here. And of course I miss the Archipelago. Return of Tarzan, okay. No Jung. And no the Gulag Archipelago. The Gulag Archip, I don't know how to pronounce it in English, I'm sorry. You know that Russian book Jordan Peterson loves to hate. So you can discuss all these books. Great. Can watch all these videos. Listen to all these podcasts and be informed about these events. All right. And give you annotations to these topics. Well, so let's look at one of these contributors' pages more in more detail. Let's choose Dr. Peterson again. Forum is locked. Media library, podcasts. Okay, this is his media library and his podcasts and his videos. And in the middle are his posts. Let's try the forum. Platform subscription. Subscribe for $10 annual. Access to all contributors' forums. Your own ThinkSpot user page includes unique postings, privilege, and verified icon. Okay. He is subscribed to more than one contributor to receive an additional 25% of your purchase. I mean, $10 per month is more than fair, but this is the special beta period offer, so the price will surely go up. Note, does not include contributor subscriptions. Oh, okay, this is the platform subscription. And then I have to pay subscribe to all the contributors I want to interact more closely. Newsletter. Okay, this is really not bad to have access to Jordan's annotations and reading the annotations of famous people can help a lot to appreciate known books more. You know, like on some movie DVDs there was the director or some super fans to give their remarks to the film. I like this kind of stuff. But now we have a special beta offer of $50 per year. Ooh, okay, online university courses. Monthly live Q&A. Okay, he's offering a lot. Okay, everybody have to decide for themselves how much they want to pay for what he has to offer. I don't want to judge this offer. I believe there are some great bullet points. Let's leave it like this. So let's have a look at a navigation bar. Search, all right. Here I can shop probably for subscriptions and books and whatever. Notifications. From the people I've subscribed. Account settings, support, my saved media, invite a friend, sign out. I really like the support features. It's really transparent if you compare it with other platforms. Let's have a short look about the FAQs. Oh, yes, you have to be 18 years old to register. We talked about the username. How do I track my activity on the platform? Okay. There's a feedback button, very nice. Why I'm unable to upload a profile picture and use emojis or memes. In accordance with ThinkSpot's commitment to quality discourse and long-form discussion, we have prohibited the use of profile pictures, emojis, and memes. We feel that profile pictures, emojis, and memes may distract from the substantial contributions being made on the platform by users and contributors alike, and wish to keep the focus on the conversations and connections at hand. Peter questions, will there be other contributors? Yes, we have a number of additional contributors we are waiting to unveil as we progress through our beta period. This is the sentence from which I concluded that I can't be a contributor and that the contributors are handpicked. Or maybe I can be a contributor sometimes in the future, and that depends on how open they make the criteria to be a contributor on this page. So this is no real substitute for Patreon for me. I mean, many contributors are not happy at Patreon because of their wishy-washy guidelines and habit to block users for their political views, even if they don't express their political views on Patreon, but on some other pages, or not even political views, just sentences with words you are not allowed to mention. Patreon has its issues. I still have a Patreon account because I have no other options. I have a Ko-fi account as well, but I'm not at Subscribestar because it's not good for authors. Yeah, well, but I had my hopes on ThinkSpot, I have to admit. Yeah, we have to see how this develops. Good, that was a short peek into ThinkSpot. I hope you enjoyed it. Please comment and like this video. You don't have to bother to subscribe to me because I'm not doing this kind of content very often. You can subscribe to me if you're interested in vlogs, writer's life, lit RPG, and web fiction. Bye bye.